requirements. So early on, you might find some little side quests that have things like turn into potion, or well, mostly turn into potions. And you're probably the first thought is probably going to go buy potions. It's about one of the worst things that you can do. And we'll go over that here in about the second or third part. But first, we're going to go back. But it's not very specific when you're out here. It's a good quick over guide. This section here, when you're over it, is not 100% accurate for Hogwarts. It doesn't include the Hogwarts drops. It doesn't include Hogsmeade as well. So select the map to get a little bit more detail. Just kind of zoom in. And you're going to see little white outlines. The first thing you're going to notice are going to be hubs. So hover over these little hubs, and it's going to give you some details on them. So Hogsmeade tells me that there's collection quests, collection chests, field guide pages, demigod statues. We'll go over demigod statues a little bit later as well. If you look at the little white parts, some of them might be gray. It means you haven't discovered it yet. Green means they are your Flufflings. If we zoom in again, those things are going to be displayed. And you can see things like ruins here that I've discovered but not activated. You can see the Flufflings that you've flown over but you haven't activated. And you can see the other flowflings that you have. If you have side quests, and some of these little hubs are going to show up as these little green dots. And as a quick note to the gray dots, if you look at your map, if you have a black flag, it means you have a quest in that area. Zoom in again, and a few more details pop up. You have things like the ancient magic hotspot, or its trials, and a few other little things here. Zoom in again, and we get the most details. We get things like a mongrel rare. Monster spawns, bandit camps, and so on. So let's zoom out and go to Hogwarts. Hogwarts is going to show somewhat of an overview of everything that you can find here. And if you're looking for something more specific, like where something might be, what you're going to want to do is collect out a flag. And it'll show you exactly what is in that wing. The next part is, when you're on your broom in the world, anything that is a non-destructible object you can pick up. So if you want to go fly by and juice some leeches, you absolutely can. It's a quick way to pick things up. The next thing is, if you have discovered any of those landmarks, and you do...
Revelio!
Revelio! It's... Oh, I need to be further out. That's my mistake. But typically, if you were further out than I was from Hogwarts, you'll notice that they sort of... landmarks that are on the map will pop up. You'll also see check marks for anything that you've already completed. And anything that you haven't found, this little piece over here, I'll still just highlight. Now in the world, you're probably going to discover things like side quests of give me a potion, or something like that. Your first thought might be to pop over to Hogsmeade and buy a potion. Don't do this. Instead, you're going to want to wait for a little bit later in the main story, not too far, and you're going to get a quest to, and this is the spoiler, the Room of Requirement. So we're going to go to this. I'll show you the things that you should probably build first to make the most of the beginning and medium part of your game. And these are going to be pieces that you can buy. So, I'd say the most important part is going to be over here. These little potion flowers. Here, and you can buy this in Hogsmeade, you'll find hopping pots. You can only have three out, and they're somewhat expensive on Moonstone. What these will do is craft you a potion every 12-ish minutes that you have learned. So be sure to learn a recipe, and these will just randomly craft you some. You notice I had three pretty good potions. The next most important thing, in my opinion, are are these. This is a material finer, I believe it's called. We go over to utility, conjuration. Material and refiner. You have a total of 3. And the cost of 15 moonstone apiece. Every 10 minutes, these will generate 10 moonstone. Kind of pays on the side. These ones are okay. If you look at herbology, go over the tables later. All the way down here are chopping stations. We only have 3 again. And it will randomly generate you 1 leaf cutting every 9 minutes. It's not bad for early game as well. The third generator that doesn't require a lot of input is also the fertilizer maker. I like to call it 2. Every 4 minutes, leaves will create a fertilizer maker, and they're fairly cheap and easy to construct. We only have 3 like the other constructors. How these ones work is growing seed. Go to inspect the source of growth, and you'll notice that it has a yield. And a fertilizer? It increases the yield by 1. It doesn't matter what the plant is, it only increases the yield by 1. All tables that are usable like a crafting station there, or a growing station, have a limitation of only 7 in the building. So you have small, medium, large. And all of these have, well, except the large one, have a small table, medium table, and large table. So for the small pots, you can have a total of 5 growing pots. For the medium, you can have a total of 3, just depends on the height. And for the large, you can have a total of 2 large growing pots. These are somewhat important depending on the seed types that you have. Some of these teas to be grown in medium. Some of them like the Chinese grown in medium and large. But large doesn't give you as much. The potion crafting stations are somewhat the same. But these ones only permit you to grow or craft 1 potion at a time. That should be pretty obvious once you make it. The better upgrades are 2 potion station. 3 potion station, which is kind of a weird configuration of a key, and the other ones are side by side. So one of the reasons why I was saying don't go off and buy potions is because the recipe itself is not much more expensive than the potion, and if you get these nice little tables, pots, they'll just randomly generate you a potion every couple of minutes. So that's an easy way to finish off your side quests that require any type of potion, so you don't have to craft it yourself. Now, if you do go get the recipe and you don't have the ingredients or you can't find them, so like you need the death ingredient, quick and easy way to find those are going to be Hogsmeade. You can find them from not J. Pippin, but the Magic Neep. He also sells some of the recipes for, not recipes, but seeds. And you can find the other ones over here at Dogweed and Deathcap. And this is the one that also sells you your weaponized vegetables. So, the mandarin, the cabbage, and that big old spitting plant. Also, the big old spitting plant can only fit in the large box. So, you probably only want to buy the largest tables, even though it is the most expensive. But once you get a little setup going like this, especially with your potions and your